last time.
Shut up!
Let's keep going.
It is a dude, okay.
Owie!
Why is she still in her uniform and not in fucking normal those clothes? I mean, come on. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. Are you okay? His eyes are pink.
That hurt, you idiot!
Oh, my lady, I'm so sorry. Forgive your humble servant.
Huh? How do you know who I am?
I beg your forgiveness. I was not expecting to lose control of the ball.
Wait! Kenta!
Dropping to his knee, my loyal butler is... What? Before me. Normally, I'd say this is far from enough for hitting me with a flying ball, but...
Get up! You're gonna blow my cover!
My lady. His butler? Oh my god.
No, my lady's tough here. Get on your feet before someone sees you. What are you doing here?
He stands back and gives me a sheepish grin. My lord sent me here to keep an eye on you, my lady.
It's A!
Please forgive me, Iri. Oh god. Voices are hard, you know? They're hard to do. Just anyway.
No, no forgiveness. I ordered you and all other servants to not come with.
Your brother didn't think I was very smart, so he wanted me to stick nearby and make sure you didn't get in trouble.
I'm not gonna get in trouble!
That's not what I've heard. Rumor has it that the snobby new girl is picking a fight with the school idol.
Nobody's picking a fight with me.
Why has she got one eye closed and one eye open? She's like, what? I think they were calling you the snobby one, Harry.
Those little plebs, how dare they?
That's perfect. Dot, dot, dot. Oh, you're not joking around. Dot, dot, dot. Please forgive me, my lady.
Harry!
I'd scold most servants who dare speak to me that way, but Kenta has been with me since I was barely able to walk. I decided to let him off with a light rap to the side of the head. Sorry.
You better be!
So, it's true, right? You challenged Rue?
So?
You've never cooked a day in your life.
So?
Fucking Ari. Is your plan to give Rue food poisoning? That didn't work well when you used it on Lord Darius.
That was an accident. I have his contest won. You idiot.
If you need help, Ari, I can.
I don't want your help. I want you and your sarcasm to go back to the palace.
I can.
You will.
The bell rings and bringing an abrupt end to the conversation. Kenta, the imp, bolts off before I can continue any further. See you, Ari. You can ask me for help anytime you need it.
Just go home!
He makes me so angry. I don't need his help, but I need him to go away and not blow my cover. If anyone found out who I was, the suck-ups and the manipulators would come flying out of the woodwork. My blood is boiling so hot I can barely stand it. Between Rue and Kenta, I'm going to end up having a heart attack at all this rage. I'd really want to stay around and play some basketball, maybe see if they have a softball field to bat some balls, but Kenta isn't bothered leaving yet. He's still practicing with some of the guys from my class. I'm not surprised that he's already made friends with them. Kenta has a light-hearted charm that tends to get past the defenses of the heart. I guess I could stay for a bit longer and get a few more shots in. I'm gonna have a drink before I make it. Also, I'm gonna totally change the voice up because it's kind of breaking my voice a bit. So yeah. She's gonna play some basketball, I guess. If he's stuck over there, he's out of sight and out of mind, I can have some fun still. What sort of drill should I run today? I'll just start with some basic shooting drills. 8 shots as quickly as I can from around the 2-point area, which is inside there. My first shot is perfect from perfect results, perfect form. The second shot, while a tad bit sloppy at first, barely touches the rim as it goes in. As I release the third shot, I know I screwed up. My release was almost full second past the optimal point. As I expect, it catches the rim and goes flying away. I dive forward and grab it before it bounces in the other courts and some pleb tries to steal it from me. Unfortunately, it brings me face to face with the game I've been trying to pretend doesn't exist!
Ooh. Oh yeah.
Kenta has the ball. Sweat glistens on his tan skin as he nimbly darts through the defenders. His footwork is precise and deft. Years of training with me have paid off. This particular screenshot was on the, if you go to the page on Steam. In the library, it's one of the shots that are in the background of all the info. Anyway, let's go on. He really did pay attention to those lessons I gave him. I'm impressed for such a moment. for a moment. Having a component servant is always something to be proud of. A glint of excitement flashes through those sparkling amethyst eyes. He's seen what I saw, the perfect chance for the score. His blinding speed and agility let him dodge through the lesser players. With a mighty jump, he leaps and releases the shot. Perfect. The game ends with Kenta being the victor. He was good. Not as good as me, but I can tell he paid attention in lessons. But, okay, whatever. Kenta flashes me a victorious ring and comes over.
Oh, did you see me win?
I saw you almost miss the shot.
You liked it, huh?
I most certainly did not. It was insufficient. Inefficient.
I'm glad you enjoyed watching me play.
I'm not glad to watch you do anything, Kenta. I told you to go home!
And I told you that His Highness told me to keep an eye on you, Ari.
Kenta flashes a steering smile and winks. His challenge have helped us get out of trouble in the past, but I'm not going to allow it to work on me.
You've been, what the fuck is that word? I've been your subordinate for years. You aren't trying to tell me to abandon you in your greatest challenge, are you?
That's exactly what I'm saying. Go away!
Yeah, I changed the voice to that voice because I find it more fun. Kenta, thankfully, starts to walk towards the door. I think I'm almost rid of the menace when he grabs the ball and starts dribbling towards me.
Let's settle this with a game of horse. If I win, I can stay by on your side and help you beat Rue. But if I lose, I go home and accept my punishment from the Crown Prince Katira.
Why would I accept such a stupid challenge?
I just fucking fucked up the voices.
Oh, are you chicken?
I am not chicken!
Yeah, I'm not doing bum bum
bum. I make it pay for that. Give me the ball!
Okay, I think I got it.
Horse, an easy to understand game, where we have to make the shots.
Yeah, okay. I know how to play horse. Start off with a trick shot that Kenta don't duplicate from the outside of the court.
Get going down, Kenta!
Don't count me out on the first letter.
Back and forth, back and forth. Either I'm getting sloppy or Kenta has been hiding his talent. But he manages to keep up with me. Even scoring horse without the E on me. He's got the ball again, drops a simple shot from the three throw line. I step up, ready to duplicate it, when I feel Kenta's breath on the nap of my nap of my neck. What the fuck is a nap of my neck? Oh god, I need a burp. Oh, that was gross, and oh god, it's in my mouth. No, it's fine. The scent of lavender shampoo mingles with a sharp tang of sweat on my nose.
What are you doing?
Just watching.
But hovering under my shoulder?
Does that bother you?
No!
But it does. I keep glancing over my shoulder to see what my servant is doing. Nothing. Every time I glance back. But I know he's going to do something to thwart me. I'm used to being with Kenta, but there's something unnerving with him so close to me. Focus. Focus. Shoot! There's a ball bounce.
Nice try.
You cheated!
And miss. I did nothing to interfere with your shot.
Fine, you still have to make it again. Let's see how you like me hovering over you.
I like being close to you.
Even though... oh, this is weird. Okay, even though I might as well be glued to him, Kenta sinks the easy shot without a single moment of hesitation. I lost.
To Kenta.
Fuck ya!
As much as this upsets me, I'm just a little glad that I have a competent helper to help me with something that I've never done before.
Fine, you win! You'd better have some amazing cooking skills, Kenta. What else are you?
Like, we'll learn together. I've got practice with the team tomorrow, so let's meet up on Wednesday at the library.
You've been here a day and you're already on the basketball team?
You should totally join as well.
No!
That's too bad. I'm heading home to get cleaned up. See ya, Ari.
It is still a victory even if Kenta helps me.
Okay. I sit down in my seat, feeling the weight of the world on my shoulders. Last night was not a good one for sleep. I kept having dreams of Friday. I was trying to bake a cake, two stories tall, but it was falling apart. I had to duck it and dive out of the way to prevent myself from being crushed. Okay. I shake my head. I don't have the time to waste thinking about stuff like that. I've got two showdowns to face now. I'm not prepared enough for either of them. What are two showdowns? Oh man, I'm not very good at this. Remembering shit. But there was a lethargy that is settling over me as I look out the window. I know things are going to turn out well, so why do I need to be worried? A white puffy cloud just by it. That's a Camelonium bus. I wonder if we're going to have rain today. My brain is going under snail's pace, but there isn't anything that I can get running. Everything is boring in this classroom. Math class starts promptly, then when the bell rings, I try to outperform Rue, but I can't keep up. My arm feels like it's made of lead, and my feeble strength is not enough to lift it. I want to go outside and take a walk. This class is a waste of time. I established my dominance yesterday. I proved my worth, so why do I need a second day of it? That's a good idea. I stand up and grab my bag. Fucking teacher, is there something wrong, Ari? I already know this, so I'm gonna take a walk. I'll be back for history. Suddenly, the class breaks out laughing, and the teacher is shaking her head with dismay. Ari, while that may have been acceptable at your old school, here, you must stay until the end of class. That's a waste of time! Sit down, Ari. I recognize that tone. That's the same tone that the lady in waiting takes with me when she wants to disagree with me. So, some common teacher thinks she can order me around. Have a good day! If you do not sit down, I'm going to have to send you to the principal's office. And just like that, the lady in waiting, she plays the high authority card. This is so aggravating. I don't want to be here. The thought catches me off guard. No, I don't. I do want to be here. I need to beat my brother. I can't walk out and let him win this. Slowly, I lower myself back in my seat. You win this round, teacher. I try to focus on my textbook, but the quiet chatter around me is breaking my concentration. Male classmate.
Can you believe her?
She's such a winner!
Who does she think she is?
Such impudent peasants. If they knew who I was, they wouldn't even be think about saying those nasty whispers. They pay their reverence. It is because of everything I've done. Right? My status as a legend, not because I am royalty. That's just the icing on the cake of this wonderful me. Do the servants think this way? My brother thinks of me as a weirdo. I skipped lots of lessons with him. I do my best to tune them out and focus on me studying, on my studying, even if it's worthless to me. Fucking Ari.